Hey my lovely viewers, a huge welcome to my channel. Today I'll be showing you a sample of a lesson plan based on the title Plants Around Me with the subtitle Parts of a Plant. So let's get started. To begin with, you have to write title Plants Around Me, subtitle Parts of a Plant. Then specific objectives or aim, here students will be able to identify the different parts of the plants and understand the functions of each part of the plant. And then comes the previous knowledge. Here students are aware of the different types of plants and their names. And then comes the set induction, the most vital part of the lesson, as I have already said before. Here the teacher should begin with an activity, something like nature walk. Teacher should instruct the students to take a rough notebook with them when they go for a nature walk. Teacher should take the class for a nature walk around the school ground. Teacher should ask students to look at some plants and see if they can identify their parts. Let students observe the parts that are visible to them and which are not. Students should make a note of the observations in their rough book. And then comes the procedure. Here, the materials required will be a potted plant and a chart showing the parts of the plant to the students. Teacher should bring all the students back to the class, show the potted plant to the students and elicit the parts of the plant and their functions with the help of the potted plant. Now, with the help of the chart, teacher should explain the parts of the plant in detail. Teacher should explain that the body of a plant can be divided into two main parts. The part below the surface of the ground is called the root, and the part above the ground is called the shoot. It consists of the stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits. And then teacher should explain the roots. She should say a plant has roots. The roots grow below the surface of the ground. Roots support the plant by holding it firmly in the soil. They absorb water and nutrients from the soil and pass them to the stem. And then comes the stem. Teacher should say the stem of the plant grows above the surface of the ground. Stem carries food and water to all parts of the plant. It gives support to the plant by bearing the leaves, flowers, and fruits. Teachers can say, although potatoes grow below the surface of the ground, it is called a stem. This type of stem is called underground stem. And then branches. Teacher should say, branches are parts of the stem. The branches of a tree grow from the trunk or stem. Leaves, flowers, fruits, and thorns grow on the branches. And then leaves. All the plants have leaves. Leaves make the food for the plant, and therefore they are also known as the food factory or the kitchen of the plant. Some plants have big leaves, for example, lotus, banana, etc., whereas some plants have small leaves, for example, coriander, mint, etc. And then flowers. Most plants have flowers. A bud blooms into a flower. A flower is usually the most beautiful part of a plant. The three prominent parts of the flower are petal, sepal, and stalk. Flowers are of different sizes, shapes, and colors. Most flowers have a sweet smell. For example, rose, lily, etc. And then, fruits. Teacher should say something like, a flower changes into a fruit. Fruits are of different kinds. There are fruits in different colors, sizes, tastes, and flavors. Most fruits have seeds inside them. The fruits protect the seeds within them. Some fruits have only one seed, for example, mango, cherry, jamun, plum, etc. Some fruits have more than one seed, for example, papaya, watermelon, and apple. Pineapple is a fruit with no seeds. Then, teacher should say about seeds. Seeds are of many kinds. They come in different colors and sizes. Some are tiny like rice and wheat seeds, and some are big like the mango seed. The seed has a baby plant inside it. And finally, teacher should explain about thorns. Some plants have thorns. Thorns keep animals away from plants. For example, lemon and rose plants have thorns on them. plants having thorns should be discussed with the help of another chart. And then comes the closure. Teacher should divide students randomly into four groups. Teacher should provide one live specimen of a plant to each group. Ask the students to carefully observe the plant given to them. Teacher should ask students to observe its parts, that is roots, stem, leaves, fruit, etc. Here, teacher should provide different plants to the children, that is to the different four groups. One may be a small herb, the other creeper, climber and shrub, etc. Teacher can carefully uproot the plant and show the children the roots. The plant has to be replanted later. Teacher should mention that even if the plant looks different, the function of the parts of their plant are the same. And then after the closure comes the recapitulation. Teacher should ask the students to complete the classwork sheets being given to them, and teacher should assist them to complete it. So this is it, friends. I hope you have liked this sample. If yes, then please let me know by giving me a thumbs up and share my video to my friends and subscribe to my channel. Till then, bye-bye.